Yo, what is going on, guys? Jack here, and welcome to episode 4 of Tracksuit to the Top, here with Lewis FC in the Ryman Premier League. Hopefully you guys are good. Today I have for you guys a rather unexpected game against Plymouth FC in the FA Cup first round, a game that I didn't even know we were going to be playing in after the previous episode. It has been a little while since the previous episode in terms of in-game time. I've played a lot of games. The reason for that being is that I am back at home now, reunited with my PC for Christmas. I am going to be going back to obviously work in London on Football Manager, but I am now going to be back with my PC, so you should hopefully notice a subtle improvement in the quality of this series compared to the previous 3 episodes from this series onwards. Anyway, you may also notice my voice is a little scratchy, so I don't want to ramble on for too long, but as I mentioned, there is a fair bit to cover, and as you can see here, top of the league, having a laugh. We've caught back up with Grey Zone. They've been on a poor run of form. But anyway, as I mentioned, there has been a substantial amount of games. I'm going to focus on our FA Cup run in a second, but firstly looking at our league games. You can see we bounced back from what had been a pretty rough run of results in the league, having drawn 3 of our last 4 and lost the other game to Grays by beating Enfield Town 3-0. A great result. Talat Kamugaridze and Sam Crabb with the goals there. Enfield Town kept really, really quiet. That was a really good performance because they are not a bad team by any means in this division. We then beat Leiston 4-2. And you can see again, Neven getting on the score sheet twice. Trillivan getting on. And Sam Cole as well. Sam Cole playing really well lately. He's just been a great player so far this year. He's got 5 goals in 15 games from left midfield. And of course, we are still sticking with our 4-4-2 system. So that's pretty darn impressive. Obviously, Darian Neven has been fairly good for us. He has had a little bit of time out of injuries. Obviously, he did miss 5 weeks. He has now had a nice little run back in the team. And as you can see, he's retaining his goal-scoring form that he had previously. Anyway, the next result was against Witham. Another win. Fagami getting the goal for us there that settled it. Pendulu got a late consolation goal for them, but it accounted for absolutely nothing. We then beat Bognor Regis. I hope I said that right. Yeah, 2-0. Another good result. You can see that we also beat them in the cup. Last year, they actually finished 3rd in the division, so they were a team who did well last year in the league, and we beat them 2-0 here. Another good result. Sam Cole, as I mentioned, and Fagami again getting on the score sheet. Fagami's been a really good player for us, the 19-year-old. He's improving with his physicals, which is quite nice because he's 19, so he's got a little room for improvement. And you can see here, he's got a 6.9 average rating, so that is not too shabby at all, really. To say he's kind of playing as a second/third choice striker. He's kind of been rotated around. Anyway, the next league game, the only defeat since the Greys game, and in fact, our only instance of dropping points, a 7-3 defeat. Yes, 7-3 against Hampton and Richmond. I would show the highlights of this game, but we would be here for the next half an hour looking at them. It was a bonkers game. It really was. As you can see, they had 2 players get hat-tricks. The game was actually fairly close for a long period, and I believe at one point it was even 4-3, and we basically collapsed. In fact, it was 3-3 at one point, and we just completely collapsed. We conceded 4 goals in about the last 25 minutes, which was absolutely ridiculous, and that was a shame. To concede 7 is always slightly concerning, because perhaps it showed our frailty at the back, but I do believe that that came largely down to the fact that 4-3 down, I did elect to go more attacking to try and chase the game. Ultimately, it did backfire. Anyway, 2 more results to tell you about. We did bounce back with a clean sheet here against Tunbridge. Tunbridge actually doing very well in the league indeed. They are kind of in the top 5 or 6 teams. So to beat them 2-0 was great. To beat them in the way that we did, in the manner that we did, having gone down to 10 men after just 17 minutes was absolutely superb. So that was a great win. And then we beat Canvey Island 4-2. A great result, this one. A game that it kind of looks on the face of it like a smash and grab, but a lot of their chances were pretty poor. Canvey Islands were crippled by the fact they did have Jay Curran sent off early on, so that did play into our hands a little bit. But nevertheless, it was still an absolutely fantastic result for us, and one that I am incredibly happy to say that we got, because I didn't expect it, if I'm honest, to win in that manner, but we did it, and now you can see the table here. We've pulled away. Obviously, we played Billericay on the opening game of the season. We lost to Greys already. I mentioned that we beat Tunbridge. That was a good result. We beat Enfield as well in this run. So we have played some pretty tricky teams. In some ways, I'm a little bit disappointed that Hampton and Richmond is the team that we lost 7-3 to, because you look at them, they're 14th in the league. They're not particularly special. But anyway, that was that. Looking at the other competition, of course, that we've got going on, we have the FA Cup, which, as you can see here, we are in the third round for, and we've done very well in that round. Let's get up our own schedule for this. So you can see, actually, in the first game of the FA Cup run, which was the second qualifying round against Brightlingsea, who themselves are playing in a league way below us, we drew 4-4. Away, and this was disappointing, I'm not going to lie. Obviously, I talked a little bit in previous episodes about fixture congestion. Having to play a replay in the FA Cup is certainly not easy, and they actually got that replay by scoring an incredibly late goal 3 minutes into added time at the end of the game, and I was pretty annoyed at that point. However, we did bounce back with a 3-0 win. It was a convincing performance. It was the performance that I expected to have at the start of the first game. Unfortunately, Sam Cole did get sent off, so a little bit of ill discipline there, particularly unnecessary considering we were 3-0 up at the time and it was in the 88th minute. Anyway, the next FA Cup result we got was against Gloucester, isn't it? I'm going crazy. They're in the Vanarama North. They are in a league above us. And we beat them very convincingly, 4-1. So that was a great result. And perhaps will give me some confidence going into potentially next season in terms of being able to put some faith perhaps in the players we have at our disposal. Because to beat Gloucester, I'm going to keep saying Gloucester. I have no idea why, because there isn't a Chester in the name. Let's move on. Bognor Regis. I probably said that one wrong too, but we beat them. We beat them in the league. We beat them in the FA Cup. That was a great result. And that was how we got to where we are now, which is the FA Cup first round, which is really good. It means that we've earned ourselves a game against Plymouth. And Plymouth right now, you can see they're in League Two. If we look at the league table, they're 17th, so they're not going to be a pushovers. However, I hope that we can go out there and really give them a game and hopefully take the game to them, because it'd be great to go on a little FA Cup run. I'm not going into this game really anticipating too much, but an FA Cup run is certainly going to help our finances. They've been a little bit kind of on the down. As you can see, we were 28 grand in the red, you know, we were in debt, but our little cup run has seen us now get a little bit of money in the bank, and it'd be nice to continue that trend by perhaps going on a bit more of a cup run. If we could somehow get to the third round, that would be absolutely incredible to go and take on you know, a Championship or Premier League team potentially, but we have got to take this one game at a time. So anyway, let's get into this team selection. So in terms of how I'm actually going to line up today, I'm really not sure who to go with, because we're playing away at Plymouth, and the dilemma that I've got is that kind of my defensive tactic is a defensive tactic for teams around our level who are going to look to attack us, and then we'll try to hit them on the break. And it's quite, well, it is, it's an incredibly defensive tactic. We've got a few injuries as well. Wolder's out injured, which is a shame because he's fairly useful and he has pretty good legs, which could be important in this game. We have got Branford, though, back, who was, I believe, he's suspended. So it's good to have him back for this game. As I said, I don't really want to defend. I'm almost tempted just to try and give it our all and go with our standard tactic, which could be absolute suicide here. Or it could work absolute wonders and I'll be hailed a genius by everyone. Looking at the average range, I didn't really talk too much earlier about our players, but Henry Muggeridge has definitely been our best player this year. He's just had a superb average rate, and the right back's easily one of the best players in our team. You can see here, he's got a 7.36 average rate, and he's been absolutely superb. And even, as well, has done really well for us. Obviously, the former Charlton trainee has been a good goal scorer for us. He's had team's top goal scorer with 9. Overall, defensively, we've been very good. Players like Page, Elphick, and Talak have all been the top performers, which is a kind of good sign, and I'm hoping we can put some faith in them here and maybe go out and attack. I think the only change I am going to make is I'm actually going to switch our fullbacks to defend, and the reason I'm going to do that is because I don't want them to wander up too high up the pitch. I want us to stick with kind of a solid back four. I don't want us to be caught out with players out of position. Looking at how they're going to line up, they're playing three at the back. They're not playing any fullbacks either, so there might be some space to be found in behind them. So hopefully our wide mid set to attack can really look to hit this space, perhaps even on the break. I kind of feel good about this game off what I can see of how they're going to play. Obviously, as I mentioned, it's a risk how we are playing. and I've confused Neven by telling him I expect us to win, but I'd like to see us win, and I think this is a winnable game, particularly how they're playing with three at the back. They could be inviting some pressure onto themselves. However, they have got superior quality, and that is going to be an issue, and within 18 seconds we find out what that issue is, because that is absolutely incredible. I am back on my new PC, you guys will be pleased to know. So we have got glorious 3D action now. So we have got close highlights just like this, so you guys can watch the goals in 3D. I know that's something that people complained about with the Arsenal series. With me now being back on my PC, that's something I can actually do. Anyway, that's not the start I wanted. Hopefully we can actually, you know, book our ideas up here. As I mentioned, or was mentioning before we conceded, Plymouth have superior quality. There is no doubt in my mind about that. But I'm hoping we can give them a good game here. They are four divisions ahead of us, so I guess in that sense, they are favourites every day of the week, and it's going to take one hell of an upset to beat them. But I'd like to dream that perhaps we can, you know, perhaps we can, you know, go on a little bit of a cup run and maybe get something going for us. I'm actually immediately changing my system. I've already scrapped the game plan of sorts. I think we're going to just change things up, because I'm already incredibly conscious of what I've witnessed in terms of their attacking presence. I'm actually going to switch to counter. I'm going to get our centre mid pairing of Branford and Randall both playing defensive to drop back. I'm dropping Crabbe as well in just to help in the midfield, because they are playing three centre mids, and that's already an area where it looks like we're getting overrun, even though he can't play there. I'm still going to be relying on Cole and Brinkhurst maybe to hurt them on the break, but I think we need to play a little bit more defensively than we are already, because right now they are looking ever so threatening. So I'm hoping we can match them in midfield. Neven, get there! Bury it! Oh, that was a chance! Brinkhurst! Neven! Yes! 1-1! Let's go! Darian Neven, the Charlton trainee, his 10th goal of the season. It's been a decent first year. I thought he'd squandered the chance when the first one went a-begging, but he stayed alive to the threats and the ball. Brinkhurst picks him out. He finds a little bit of space in the 8-yard, but within the 8 yards, of course. I was about to say within the 8-yard box, but there is not an 8-yard box on a football pitch, so that would be impressive. And he gets a nice little finish there. However, he now gets injured in FM style. That will allow me to bring on Sam Crabbe there. Unfortunately, I don't have an abundance of centre mids, and given how we're playing right now, we're suddenly short of a centre mid. Napa, can you play centre mid? No, you can't. Matty Crabbe, can you play centre mid? No, you can't. Oh dear. Well, this is exactly what I didn't want to happen, because I think we're going to have to play someone out of position in the centre attacking mid role. I'm going to play Fagami there, I think. Not ideal. Really not ideal. I think we're just going to have to swap it around. Crabbe's actually okay at playing centre attacking mid amazingly. Of course, he can play right back. Unfortunately for me, he just can't play centre mid, but he can do a job there, I think, for us. So we're going to stick with that. Passionately going to tell Fagami, I believe there's a lot to come from him. He has got a knock. That's one of the reasons he wasn't starting. I'm hoping that's not going to hurt him too much. Obviously, this game can't go to added time because it's the FA Cup. And it won't go to to extra time either if they're winning 2-1, which right now they are with that goal there. And given the amount of players we had in the box here, there's just no one picking up anyone. And the ball falls into a little bit of space after a bit of a mix-up at the back. And Banton's just there to gobble up the opportunity, which is a shame. Unfortunately, that injury to Neven really has scuffed, not our chances, but to lose your top goal scorer is always a bit of a nightmare situation, particularly in a game this big. And now they've got a set piece. It hits the post. We ride our luck there. Right now, Plymouth all over us. But we are looking like it's going to go into half-time at 2-1, and that's okay. We are, of course, playing a team far superior to us. They have superior talent. They have the better players, the better shape in terms of their formation. They probably do have the better shape, because let's face it, we are a bit of a makeshift unit this game. But there's some positives to be taken. I'm actually going to drop Crabbe into a deep-lying forward role, just so he can play in his natural position. I think that's going to just be a little bit of a sensible change just to maximise his familiarity with what it is he's actually going to be doing on the pitch. But yeah, with a similar shape really, just going for that 4-4-2, really trying to hit teams on the break. Hope luck can be on our side, maybe we can get a chance and then take it if it comes our way. But right now, there's been very few chances in the second half. 20 minutes left on the clock. I'm going to have to, at some point, start chasing this game. But I don't want to leave us susceptible at the back in chasing. And I don't know, when you're only one goal behind, it's kind of like, do I stick or do I twist? Do I stick and hope we get that one chance? Well, my decision's been made up for me there, because now I do have to twist, because we are suddenly... we're behind, aren't we? We have to chase this game at this point. Fortunately, I can now actually switch to one of our more familiar systems, which is our more attacking system. We need two goals in 15 minutes. We need a miracle. Miracles do occasionally happen in Football Manager. I can't say I'm overly optimistic, but if we could grab a goal now with 15 minutes left, we'd make things nervy for Plymouth here. Brinkhurst, go on. Crosses it. McCormick gobbles it right up, though, straight down his throat. Looking at the stats, they've been the better team, but we've really not played that badly. I'm pretty darn happy with how we're doing against a team four divisions above us. However, they are coming on the attack now. If it suddenly 4-1 doesn't look quite as impressive, and it is going to go 4-1, which is a shame. Marvin Morgan with his second goal of the game. A little bit of an inability to defend crosses and kind of balls pinged from out wide seems to be our issue here. That's how one of their goals came in. It's how that one's come in for Morgan out on the left-hand side. And as I said, 4-1 suddenly doesn't look quite as impressive. But we are chasing the game at this point. Muggeridge whips it in. Cleared away there. That was a real chance. Unfortunately, it couldn't be directed goalwards. I'm pretty happy, to be honest, with how we've played it. I mean, if we could grab a goal here, that would be absolutely fantastic. I'd rather not concede another. But at this point, I've resigned myself to defeat and going to stick with our attacking system as they come on the attack here. Banks, great save, my son. One good thing that has come of this FA Cup run, as I mentioned earlier, is the money. The money from this run has been superb. I kind of wished it could go on a little bit longer, but to get to the first round as a team in our division is really impressive, and that's going to certainly help our finances as we do go on the attack here. Can we grab a goal? I really want a goal here. Branford with a chance. It's blocked away, unfortunately. Corner will come our way. Suddenly, we've created a fair few chances towards the end of this game. Unfortunately, however, it's going to be too little, too late. 4-1 is probably going to be how this finishes, unless there's an incredibly late goal, but it's going to be meaningless either way. But I'm pretty happy with how we've done in this FA Cup. It is 5 now, and despite that, that kind of flatters them. That kind of, it's just a result of us chasing the game. I'm pleased with the boys. As I mentioned, we're playing a team 4 divisions ahead of us. This was a game I didn't expect to win. But for portions of this game, we've actually been fairly competitive with them. And that's something that's certainly positive. I'd really like to take some of these players and, stick them in the side and keep them in the side for the coming years. And I saw a little bit of hope for that when we beat Gloucester. And I've seen a little bit more of that there. We were unlucky, boys. It just wasn't our day. I can live with that result. The first round of the FA Cup is a great achievement, considering that's beyond our minimum expectations. And it also now gives us a chance to focus on the league, where we are top. So yeah, 17 games in, things could certainly be a hell of a lot worse for us. It's a shame that we've lost in the first round, but I'm pretty happy. I'm pretty happy with what we've done there. But anyway, guys, that is going to wrap things up for today's episode. The next game is probably going to be the one against Met Police, I think. I believe that'll actually mark the halfway mark in the season, so that should be quite a nice one to do. Right now, they are a team in 17th. They're actually expected to do a lot better than that, so it'll be interesting to see if they can kind of get on a bit of a recovery mission or if we can put them to bed. But yeah, that'll be a good episode to do, particularly because, as I mentioned, halfway mark, be able to give you a bit of a reflective report on our team, who the standout performers have been and all that good stuff. As always, guys, if you have enjoyed this video, smash the like button. It really does help me out. If you've got any questions, let me know them down in the comments. I like to answer them. I like to see people chatting FM in my video comments and getting away from the stigma that YouTube comments are just like this bottomless abyss of crap. So if we can do that, that would be bloody fantastic. But anyway, thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this video and you're new here, subscribe. And other than that, guys, it is me, Jack. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.